I'm going to tell you all a coming of age story. I'm going to tell you the story about the first time I met black people. Now, I grew up in the city of Chicago, the third biggest city in the United States of America. I travel a lot. I've done comedy from coast to coast, all over the place. Big town, small town, all over the place. And a lot of people will say to me, "You're from Chicago. That's amazing. That must have been great to grow up, like where all these cultures come together. You know, all different walks of life where they all come together." And I'm like, "What the fuck, Chicago, have you read about?" Because that is not the case at all, right? We all know it's very segregated. I grew up here. I grew up on the Northwest Side. I love it there. It's great. You know, my neighbor was a little diverse, I guess. It's like 40% Hispanic, 30% Polish, and then the rest, like regular white people like me, right? You know? It was great, though. It was a good upbringing, you know? But I didn't meet black people until I was 9 years old. But again, like, I'd heard horrible things about black people. Because again, I grew up in a very blue-collar neighborhood, which blue-collar is just code for racist as fuck. That's what that is. And so I'd heard horrible things about black people. Now, my parents divorced, and my dad worked on the south side for the Chicago Park District. Now, he would take me to work for him because it was just easier, you know? You didn't have to get a babysitter, and I loved it because I was 9 years old, so I got to play basketball all day long, shoot hoops. I'm in a gym. It's a park. It's fucking awesome. So here I am, little 9-year-old Joey, shooting hoops by himself, working on my game, just learning basketball for the first time. When 9 17-year-old black guys walked into the gym. There was 9 of them. They're all about 17, 18 years old. They come into the gym. They want to play a full-court game of basketball. But we all know you can't play full court with 9 guys. You need 10. You need an even 10. So the main dude comes up to me. He's like, Yo, white boy, you want to play basketball? You want to roll with us? You want to roll with us, white boy? I'm like, roll with you? Are you asking me to join your gang? Because I'll join your gang. Let's talk about that shit. I may be 9, but I'm looking for upward mobility. Let's talk about joining this gang. I'm down. Let's talk about it, my brother. Let's do this. He's like, "Nah, white boy, you crazy. You want to play basketball with us?" I'm like, "Okay, well, let me just get this straight. Basketball first, gang banging later. I just want to get the schedule down. Okay, I'm very punctual. You'll find that to be an asset in this gang. I just want to let you know. Okay?" It's like, "You fucking crazy." So we go to play the game. Right when we're about to start, the guy who's guarding me, he's real cool, nicest dude. He said, "Listen, I'm going to let you get some shots off. We're just here to have some fun. Don't worry about it. I don't want you freaking out and stuff. We're just gonna have a good time." I'm like, "Oh, cool, thanks, such a nice guy." Very first play of the game, my point guard catches me on the wing, sees me wide open, kicks me the ball. I catch the ball. Again, but I'm a fucking 9-year-old. I don't wanna play basketball. So I catch him, like, "Oh shit, what do I do? He's like, "Shoot it, white boy, shoot it." So I fucking just chuck it up randomly. Like, terrible form, just chuck it up. Guess what? I scored. I fucking scored. That's right, yeah. I banked it. They gave me shit for not calling glass. But still, it went in, right? It went in. And everyone on my team was fucking jacked up. Like, "Yeah, fucking little white boy right here. Look at this fucking little white boy." Everyone on the other team was pissed. They were giving their guy shit. "Like, you just let a white boy score on you. What the fuck is wrong with you? Little white boy just scored on your ass. Little Opie Taylor just scored on your motherfucking ass. Little Opie Taylor." And my only thought was, what are a bunch of 17-year-old black kids doing watching the Andy Griffith Show? That's a weird reference for a bunch of high school black kids. I mean, that show is on in reruns very early in the morning. I don't know, they're getting up that early to watch reruns of the Andy Griffith Show? It's weird. So we go back on the court, we make a defensive stop, we're coming right back up the court. Again, I got a great point guard, you know, he's coming up, he does a little fake, he kicks me the ball. This time I catch it with confidence, I step back, good form, swish, fucking swish. Everybody's fucking going nuts now, right? Everyone on my team is like, "We got Larry Bird on our goddamn team. That's motherfucking Larry Bird on our team. We got Larry Legend in this motherfucker. How about that shit?" All the other guys are like, "You are not black. What the fuck is wrong with you? You let that motherfucker just score on you? What the fuck is wrong with you?" They're just losing their mind, right? I'm doing the Crip walk, right? I'm having a fucking good time, you know? Fucking invented that shit. Wasn't even around back then. I'm a pioneer. Having a great time. Come back up the court. We make another defensive stop. As we're coming up, the guy who I just scored on twice, he's pissed. He stops me. He says, "Listen, little white boy, I just gave you 2 freebies. You just got 2 freebies, okay? You try to shoot that ball again, son, I'm gonna fucking stuff you. I'm gonna fucking stuff you, son. Don't you try to shoot that fucking ball again." You notice how I didn't blink? Neither did he. Yeah, it's fucking frightening. So I responded by saying, "I apologize, sir. I did not realize the circumstances of this game. I did not mean to upset you. I will not be shooting the rock, as you called it, again. I'm sorry. Let's just go back to me becoming a GD, because I want to fucking deal with that. Let's just hash that out. Let's come up with a game plan, right? I'm sorry again." So we come up. Again, I got this point guard. He's a great point guard. He wants to feed the hot hand. He does a couple moves to the inside. Looks like he's going for a layup. Just fucking kicks the ball right back out to me. Right when I catch it, I look up. The dude is already in air to block me. Already in air. He's fucking way up here, fucking balls above my head, just fucking casting a shadow, casting a shadow over the gym. And I'm like, what the fuck do I do? Holy shit. But then listen, everyone. I grew up watching Michael Jordan. I know how to create a shot. So I take one dribble to the side. I fade. I fire. I fucking score. It is fucking crazy. Everybody loses their mind, right? Everyone on my team is like, he's NBA Jam on fire now, motherfuckers. That's right. He's got flame on that basketball. He's NBA Jam on fire, motherfuckers. Everyone on the other team was just like, this is fucking bullshit. We go crazy. They put me up on their shoulders like we just won the NBA championship, right? We start cutting down the net, which was crazy because we had a lot more game to play. I don't know why we're cutting down. It was fucking 3-0. I don't know why we're cutting down the net, right? But the only thought in my head was this. Black people are awesome. This is the most fun I've ever had in my goddamn life. This is crazy. Who are these crackers on the north side talking shit about my teammates, right? Moral of that story is every 9-year-old deserves 9 17-year-old black guys, and we will fucking be a better country for it, right? Cops and protesters hugging, come together through the fucking desire of sport. It's amazing.